in service trade, just in case you say you don't get it. That only goes on when it's consecrated. It's a symbol, the sign of consecrated. Yeah. You got some questions? We did that. That's the point before. After the concert. Hey, what's your saying? It needs the attempt to measure that.
I think it's just, it's not just
COVID. Do you want to receive or in Chalice?
I will be. Yeah, so I'll do that as well.
Yeah, okay.
Good morning. The psalm this morning is "The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel." The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. We'll run that one again. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. It'll be fine on the night. The Alleluia is the Jubilate Alleluia 5-4-1. So if you remember, stick your finger in the 5-4-1 so that you're ready for it when it comes.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. I suspect a plot. Because a sizable proportion of the parish this morning are sitting in somebody else's seats. There's been a move around, so only serves to confuse me. You're very welcome to Mass, those here, and I suppose those gathered by the live stream are where you normally are at this time on a Sunday morning. But you're all very welcome. We're offering Mass for the repose of the soul of Pamela's husband Bernard, who died recently. So we remember him and Pamela and all those who remember him in our prayers this morning. First things first, we need to sort out the children. Not sort them out so much as just gently get rid of them. God, everybody's in the wrong place. Are you taking the book? Okay, where to go? You know where you're going? You do? Okay, off you go. Brother Jack. Hiya. Good morning. If anybody's thinking of a shepherding role in the Christmas Nativity, thanks to Monica, we've already got two sheep have arrived in good time, so they'll be taken care of. There you go. So let's gather ourselves for prayer. We bring to God all that's in our hearts, all that causes us delight, and all that weighs us down. And let's pray perhaps in a particular way this morning for the Synod, as that now continues, and just watching the news for peace in our world. And for that justice without which peace cannot come about. And for all that we can do, that God strengthen us. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us, and bring us one day together to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who pray to you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and who reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Let me sing to my friend the song of his love for his vineyard. My friend had a vineyard on a fertile hillside. He dug the soil, cleared it of stones, and planted choice vines in it. In the middle, he built a tower. He dug a press there too. He expected it to yield grapes, but sour grapes were all that it gave. And now, inhabitants of Jerusalem and men of Judah, I ask you to judge between my vineyard and me. What could I have done for my vineyard that I have not done? I expected it to yield grapes. Why did it yield sour grapes instead? Very well, I will tell you what I'm going to do to my vineyard. I will take away its hedge for it to be grazed on, and knock down its wall for it to be trampled on. I will lay it waste, unpruned, undug, overgrown by the briar and the thorn. I will command the clouds to rain no rain on it. Yes, the vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel, and the men of Judah that chosen plant. He expected justice, but found bloodshed, integrity, but only a cry of distress. The word of the Lord.
The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. The vineyard of the house of the Lord of Israel. You brought a vine out of Egypt. To plant it, you drove out the nations. It stretched out its branches to the sea, to the great river it stretched out its shoots. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. Then why have you broken down its walls? It is plucked by all who pass by. It is ravaged by the boar of the forest, devoured by the beasts of the field. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of God of hosts, turn again, we implore. Look down from heaven and see. Visit this vine and protect it, the vine your right hand has planted. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. And we shall never forsake you again. Give us life that we may call upon your name. God of hosts, bring us back. Let your light shine on us, and we shall be saved. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. There is no need to worry, but if there is anything you need, pray for it, asking God for it with prayer and thanksgiving, and that peace of your hearts and your thoughts in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers, fill your minds with everything that is true, everything that is noble, everything that is good and pure, everything that we love and honour, and everything that can be thought virtuous or worthy of praise. Keep doing all the things that you learnt from me and have been taught by me and have heard or seen that I do. Then the God of peace will be with you. This is the word of the Lord. Says the Lord, because I have made known to you everything I have learned from my Father. Alleluia, alleluia, praise to Christ, the Word of life. Glory, praise, and
the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the chief priests and elders of the people, "Listen to another parable. There was a man, a landowner, who planted a vineyard. He fenced it round, dug a wine press in it, and built a tower. Then he leased it to tenants and went abroad. When vintage time drew near, he sent his servants to the tenants to collect his produce. But the tenants seized his servants, thrashed one, killed another, and stoned a third. Next he sent some more servants, this time a larger number, and they dealt with them in the same way. Finally he sent his son to them. 'They will respect my son,' he said. But when the tenants saw the son, they said to each other, 'This is the heir. Come on, let us kill him and take over his inheritance.' So they seized him and threw him out of the vineyard and killed him. Now when the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants?" They answered, "He will bring those wretches to a wretched end and lease the vineyard to other tenants who will deliver the produce to him when the season arrives. Jesus said to them, Have you never read in the scriptures? It was the stone rejected by the builders that became the keystone. This was the Lord's doing, and it is wonderful to see. I tell you then that the kingdom of God will be taken from you and given to a people who will produce its fruit. The Gospel of the Lord.
We were reflecting last week. Last week's gospel comes immediately before this week's gospel. And Jesus is speaking in both gospels to the chief priests and to the elders of the people. So he's talking to the top men, the top religious men of the society. We reflected last week about the need for what was the expression that it does what it says on the tin. And that's our challenge, to do what we say, to put into practice in our day-to-day lives what we say we are about as people who wish to follow in the footsteps of the Lord Jesus. And it's a really hard thing to do. Somebody said to me in the course of Sunday, because I'd said that I don't think that God is terribly worried about religion, really. Are you trying to do yourself out of a job? Then you can have your Sundays off. Not quite. But I am convinced firmly that this is not where we live our faith, in here. This isn't practicing our faith, coming to Mass. Practicing our faith is what we do when we leave here, and we come here to hear God's word. We come here to be aware that we're not alone on the journey, that we have sisters and brothers walking the way with us, and we come to be strengthened by the sacraments, that the Lord Jesus may strengthen us from within to be able to live out our Catholic Christian faith. That first reading is a beautiful, almost a romantic section of Isaiah. Let me sing of my friend a song of love for his vineyard. And so this text, you may have twigged, parallels the text in the Gospel, the story that Jesus tells of the person who planted a vineyard, dug the soil, planted the vines, built a tower, dug a press, and expected it to yield grapes. But sour grapes were all that it gave. It's interesting, in both Gospels, last week and this week, Jesus asks a question. Last week, it was, which of the two boys did the will of the Father? The one who said, I won't go, and then went, or the one who said, certainly I'll go, and then didn't go to work in the vineyard? Same images there, both weeks for us. Because it is one of the great images of Israel. Not the state of Israel that we have today, but the chosen people of God. And last week they knew the answer. They knew which boy had done the Father's will. Just, I suppose, as we know answers to all kinds of questions. And then again today, he asks the question, what will he do? What will the owner of the vineyard do to these tenants who've killed his son? That's the image of Jesus is the son whom God sends. And so for us, knowing the answers is really only one step on the journey. It's then how we apply the answers in our day-to-day lives. And we don't have to look very far in our world, God help us, to know what needs to be done. To know who and where the brokenhearted are. To know who and where the people are who need. Maybe just a word, maybe just a smile, maybe just a going around my famous example of Morrison's. And the person who rams their trolley into the queue before you when you're just about to get to the till and you think, and all of a sudden there's this mountain of stuff to be, you know. Maybe just a smile. Certain. I've all the time in the world. Yeah. We don't know the difference that smile might make. We don't know what the person's got going on in their head. What kind of anger they're trying to work through as that then gets expressed as the trolley gets jammed in front of yours. And you'll have millions of examples better than mine. And that's why we come here. Not because we walk out of here saints, but we might just have a little bit of extra space in our own lives that can make room for others. Because we've heard God's word, and we've been together, and we've seen what a motley bunch we are. Nobody's walking around here smelling of incense. Deacon Peter, no, that's not your aftershave. No. We're all struggling in the same boat to try and find safe landing. So as we pray the Mass, let's go back, that God, yeah, it would be good if in small ways, in significant ways, ways that nobody will ever notice and give me an award for, if I could just now and again do what it says on the tin and live as you would have me live. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I believe in God. And Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From whence He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. So we pray in first place, as always, for the Church, for all those who seek to follow the example and the teaching of the Lord Jesus. We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and for our own Bishop, Terence Patrick. And we pray now for the synod and for that gift of listening to each other, learning from each other, walking perhaps a mile in somebody else's shoes, for the members of the synod, that they may be open to the action and the voice of God's Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy. For this parish family here at Our Lady's, that we may always draw hope from God's word and strength from the sacraments, that our lives may make a difference for good in the world. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for those in civil authority, we pray for those who have it in their power, in their hands, to end injustice. Lord, in your mercy. For those who are sick in body, in mind, and in spirit. We pray for all those who care for them. We pray in first place for their families and for the healthcare professionals who bring their skill, their knowledge, their wisdom, their humor, their patience. Lord, in your mercy. And remembering Bernard, we pray for those who have died and gone before us. That they may see God face to face. And for all those who grieve and all those who mourn, that the nearness of the risen Lord might be a comfort. Lord, in your mercy. For all the prayers that we bring with us this morning as we come to pray. Lord, in your mercy. And we ask Mary, Our Lady, Our Mother, to join our prayers to hers. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Loving God, hear us as we pray with confidence and trust in Jesus' name. Amen. I think the hordes are at the gates. Are you going to put the water for me? Now, where are we going to put the grapes, do you think? In front of the altar, on the floor there in the middle? And God's word goes on to you. So we've obviously found a vineyard that produces good grapes, because we have good grapes in front of the altar. Now then, is someone going to speak to this? Are you going to explain? John, you hold it. And I'm not even there.
God's kingdom is for everyone. We want to bear our fruit for God.
Okay. Well done, well done. Give a little round of applause for the children. Will be Sisters, brothers, let's pray together that this, your sacrifice and mine, may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Saviour. He is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the hosts of angels adore you and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down upon them like the dewfall your Spirit, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Terence Patrick our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brother, your servant Bernard, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our sisters and our brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them all into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Joseph, her husband, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, God Almighty Father, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of the Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and who reign, forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace. Peace and joy. Lamb of God, the body and blood of our Lord God, our Savior Jesus Christ, and our eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. The body and drink of God, and in this condemnation, but health of mind and body. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away our sins and the sins of all the world. Bless those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. After the concluding prayer, we're going to say the prayer for the synod, which is on your newsletters. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume. Through Christ our Lord. We are here before you, Holy Spirit, as we gather together in your name. Make yourself at home in our hearts, with you alone to guide us. Teach us the way we must go and how we are to pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not let us promote disorder. Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path, nor partiality influence our actions. Let us find in you our unity, so that we may journey together towards eternal life, and not stray from the way of truth and from what is right. All this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time, in the communion of the Father and the Son, forever and ever. Amen. I'd sit down just for a moment then, please. Thank you for coming out to Mass this morning. This is Prisons Week. It's a week of prayer every year, and we pray for those who are in prison, and also for those who are also doing their time, doing their sentences, their partners, their husbands, their wives, their children, their parents. We gather all of them into our prayers. And in a particular way, in this parish, we pray for Acomb Grange prison, where the residents are our parishioners. They're part of our parish family. I celebrate Mass each week there at Acomb Grange. So we pray for them. There's a change of Mass times this week. On Tuesday, the Mass is at 9 o'clock, not 9:30. And that's because every year the bishop meets with the chaplains in the different prisons in our diocese. So I'm going up to Middlesbrough for that meeting on Tuesday. And on Thursday, Mass is at Our Lady Queen of Martyrs School and at 2:15 p.m. But you're very welcome to come along. The booking for our First Communion program is now online and is available from the front page of the parish website. The closing date is for the 12th of November. There's plenty of time to book. And the program is for those who are part of our parish family, those who live in the parish, and those whose families worship here on a regular basis. The LGBT plus ministry Mass at noon at 3 o'clock, and the doors open at 2:30. And today we're collecting in the envelopes and what you've saved through Family Fast Day. So there'll be someone at both doors of the church. We've got a wedding here. It's a bit like the parish in London where I used to work. Where we have many, many baptisms, but not too many weddings. But that's okay. That's okay. That's life. That's life. But Emma and Chris are marrying here on Saturday. And going forward, we will be having a monthly Mass in Italian for members of the Italian community and anybody else who wishes. They've got some of our parishioners who are learning Italian at the moment. They came along last time, so that's going to be in the Father Kelly room on the 21st of October. And then the matter's practical. The acoustic tiles are going into the hall. That will be a help. Help for me, certainly. I find the echo increasingly hard to hear a conversation with all the noise around. And then the diocese has given permission for us to have the tarmac, the car park, resurfaced and relined. And at the front of the church, you can see that the trees, the roots are pushing up and cracks are appearing. So unless that's done, it's going to become dangerous, especially as the winter comes on. And the diocese has happily given us permission, as you will see, to spend our own money on this. But it's an important job. So thanks very much for coming. I hope the week ahead treats you gently. Have I forgotten anything? No? We're there? Right. Let's you stand, please. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Thanks be to God.